So a lot of questions on test out, which tomorrow it's going to be called Cert Master, but that's just they're changing the name. On a lot of the earlier questions that I turned into flashcards, a lot of the like all the just answers and all the distractor. Well, it was like you had like seven options, and then you selected two of the seven options, and then you would be correct. But that's kind of hard to translate into flashcard format. Eventually, I figured it out. Do natural bristle brush and compressed air, which is the correct answer, and then get the list of the other seven things and randomize them, and then just get the first two from the randomized list and make it that and that, that and that, that and that, and then that and that. So then they're all sort of equal distractors. But here it's obvious because this is natural bristle brush and compressed air. So I personally can tell that it's a question where it was like multiple choice. It's correct. When one with good distractors shows up, I'll show you guys. I'll point them out. Okay, so here's one with proper distractors. So here it has this and this, this and this, this and this, and this and this. I'm pretty confident this is the correct one. Yep. this is another example of bad descriptors. I'm pretty confident without even... Even if I didn't see the question, I'm pretty confident I could get this one correct because this one says budget, risk assessment, and project plan, but all of these just say one thing, so... Is that really the most likely cause? Really? Who's installing non-ECC RAM on an ECC system? I feel like if you have ECC RAM, you're the type of guy to know that you have ECC RAM. I can't think of many times where you just incidentally have ECC RAM. I think DDR5 might have ECC by default, but I'm not too sure about that one. I don't know, but this seems odd. And odd enough for me to comment on it and unmute my microphone. Sorry for the pause. My mom came in to give me my AirPods. It's active RFID because it has to be powered. Passive RFID would be something like, don't quote me on this, but I'm pretty sure passive RFID is referring to the sort of RFID chip, or I think maybe NFC chip now in like your credit card. It's passive because it's not turned on until it's brought into like a range of electricity from a card reader. But again, don't quote me on this, but I'm pretty sure active RFID is something where both are powered or something. Don't quote me on that. Yeah. I messed up something here. There's a 50-50 chance I get this correct. Oh. Man, I guess I didn't mess something up. Well, I did mess something up because these aren't supposed to be functionally the same. But I guess it's sort of a good red herring, I guess. I don't know. Be right back, I'm gonna use the restroom. Oh. Oh, I need to turn off my microphone. That's what I heard a show in the background. That's why my microphone's muted. Because it doesn't need to be on.
I just sneezed and it thinks I pressed 1. I don't think I pressed 1. I just sneezed. Maybe this is referring to Windows, because I think this might be the case on Windows.
When I first did this practice question, I also got caught up on this. I'm pretty sure this isn't the case. I don't know. I don't know if this was, like, stupid, but when I got my monitor and I had a dead pixel, I just returned the monitor and got a new monitor with about the same specs. I mean, I don't know. That, you know? For breakfast, I had a frittata that my mom made, which was very good, and some leftover lasagna. I would have preferred to not have the lasagna, because including that altogether, I've had a lot of food today, but I needed to get rid of the leftover lasagna, so what can you do? For dinner, we had like Taco Bell burritos, but made at home. We used Taco Bell sauce and refried beans. It's pretty tasty. They're good burritos, and it's just bean burritos. They're good burritos, and you know, it's cheaper to make them at home if we have the ingredients, so. Yeah, that's pretty much it. The reason why I studied for an hour in this video, up until about a third of the questions, a little over a third actually, but is because I finished my flashcards today, and they're actually public now, which is cool. Let me fix my... yeah, these are actually public now, which is cool. I think this website's a little slow because of just, like, how many flashcards I have, but, you know, what can you do? Yeah, but it's basically what I've been doing for 2 days straight, so it makes sense. Go a little quicker this time. Yeah. That's probably why my computer lagged out a little bit when I was loading this webpage. But, yeah, I also used its new name, CompTIA CertMaster, instead of test out LabSim, because, you know, it's future-proofing, and it's naming that tomorrow, so even though I'm technically lying, I won't be lying tomorrow. But, yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope everybody's a good day. Oh, I woke up at, hold on. So, I woke up at, like, 5 something, like 5:30 or 5:20, and then I walked for 4 miles on the treadmill, and that went pretty well. I burned 567 calories. While I was doing that, I was washing my sheets, which I need to put on my bed still. And then my dad and I at 10 a.m. watched WWDC, which was really cool. They announced iOS 18, and of course, you know, iOS versions are a little more boring than they used to be, but I think that's fair considering how mature iOS is nowadays. But, you know, they did introduce some new AI features. That was like a third of their keynote. They introduced some like generative AI features and some improvements to Siri, and they announced their partnership with OpenAI, which has been rumored for a while, but the rumor used to be with Google Gemini, so, you know, now it's with OpenAI, which is interesting, because alternate universe, they totally would have gone with Gemini. And I think alternate universe, I could imagine Google winning that AI war that's going on right now, that ChatGPT, or OpenAI, is obviously winning now with this. Apple partnership. Well, they've been obviously winning for a while, but winning more than, you know, they're winning more now that Apple's partnering with them, you know, and stuff related to their AI is going to be on 2 billion devices, which God, that's going to need more Microsoft investment. Anyways. Yeah, so... iOS 18 looks really cool. I'm happy they're redesigning the control center. It looks almost the same, but I'm happy it's more customizable. It's really cool that you're able to put app icons anywhere on your home screen. It's surprising that it took this long. And I see a lot of people on Twitter really not liking the fact that you can like customize participating app icons, and for non-participating app icons, it just tints the icon, which I don't know. The whole thing is a little weird, right? And it's weird enough for, you know, companies like Canonical to not even officially support theming. Just crazy stuff like that. Or at least people in GNOME circle. But, you know, it's still crazy. That, you know, an open source sort of like, you know, relatively free software company like Canonical being so relatively anti-theming. And then you look at what... Then you look at Apple, and they're like weirdly pro-theming, and it's just against how it's been in the past. But hey, Microsoft is really pro Linux now, so you know, things, everything's weird. And I'm referring to GNOME. Yeah, I'm referring to this. This whole, like, please don't theme our apps thing that a lot of GNOME developers are doing. Yeah. Anyway, yeah, it's just interesting. Yeah, I don't know. I don't mind it. I might not enable it. I might enable the dark icons, but I'm not going to do any weird color theming, I don't think, unless I get really into that for some reason. You could just not do it if you want, and I don't know why other people are so into what other people do on their phones. Who cares? The generative emoji is cool. The generative images just kind of look ugly, like how generated, like AI-generated images that don't have a lot of effort put into them look. And I don't know. It was cool. I wonder how things on the 16 are going to go, because obviously they're going to have to announce new software features on the 16 and the 16 Pro. Otherwise, that would be crazy. So I wonder how else iOS 18 is going to develop and grow post-September. Yeah, I hope everybody has a great day, and yeah, see you, dude.